This is Optimal Health Daily, episode 866. Technology changes faster than us, by Ross Enamait of rostraining.com. And I'm Dr. Neil. Hey there, happy Monday. And if you're in the US, a very happy Veterans Day to you. A big thank you to all of our servicemen and women. Welcome back to Optimal Health Daily, where I simply read to you from the best health and fitness blogs for free. I cover fitness, nutrition, stress management, weight management, and lots more. Just like an audiobook, but from a bunch of different authors, and always with permission from the sites. Now, speaking of Veterans Day, consider someone you know who is in the military or is a veteran. Imagine how much a good night's sleep means to them. The Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed senses your movements and automatically adjusts to keep you sleeping comfortably through the night. Experience the smart, effortless comfort of the Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed. During the Veterans Day sale, save $1,000 on the new Sleep Number 360 Special Edition Smart Bed. Now only $1,799 plus exclusive savings for military and vets. You'll only find Sleep Number at one of their 600 Sleep Number stores nationwide. Find one near you at sleepnumber.com/OHD. And now let's get right to today's post and start optimizing your life. Technology changes faster than us, by Ross Enamait of rostraining.com. I'm back up and running after my operating system crashed last week. I had to bite the bullet and purchase a new desktop. I'm now transitioning operating systems, and I'm also simultaneously trying to figure out a new phone. When I purchased the desktop, I found out that I was eligible for a free upgrade. Therefore, I've laid to rest two dinosaurs in less than a week. Technology sure has come a long way. What was the state of art a few years ago is ancient today. Yet while technology continues to grow exponentially, I'm happy to say that the human body isn't evolving nearly as fast. Timeless Hill Sprints. If you're on Facebook, you're probably familiar with their On This Day reminder service. The reminder is typically of a picture that you shared the same day from a previous year. Last week, I was reminded of a hill sprint path that I cleared 2 years before. A few days later, I received a second reminder about how I added another 20 yards to the path. Seeing those pictures brought back memories, not just memories of clearing the path, but also memories as a child. As I've said before, my introduction to hill sprints came as a young fan of Walter Payton. I grew up watching him dominate the National Football League. Walter Payton ran hills, so I wanted to run hills. In fact, on the day that I decided to clear the path, I started by watching a video of him. I've shared it a few times on this blog before, and I can't promise that I won't share it again. It's one of those timeless clips that always inspires me to work harder. Although it's been over 15 years since Walter Payton passed, I still think of him when I'm out on the hills. I remind myself of his tenacity and relentless work ethic. It may sound crazy, but when I was younger, I used to pretend that he was watching me run hills. My goal was for Walter Payton to nod his head in approval. I always gave the hills everything I had. I wasn't finished until the hill finished me. That's how Walter Payton ran hills, so that's how I've always run them as well. Humans versus technology. By now, you are probably wondering what Walter Payton and hill sprints have in common with my computer and phone upgrades. The short answer is nothing, and that's a beautiful thing worth mentioning, particularly to the younger generation. It is nice to have something that will never be outdated. I'll never be forced to download an update. The hill works as is, and it always will. Hill sprints challenged Walter Payton, and they continue to challenge me. No one will ever be too good for the hill. It will never expire. Meanwhile, much of the world has become accustomed to faster and better everything. Society has come to expect and demand regular updates. Consequently, it's only a matter of time before today's cars, phones, computers, and televisions are outdated and obsolete. Therefore, it's no surprise that so many people assume that whatever was worthwhile in previous eras are no longer relevant today. If it's old, it must be outdated, right? That assumption could not be further from the truth. Don't be foolish enough to compare technology with the human body. The former will continue to evolve at a much faster pace than the latter. Just because you need to upgrade your technology doesn't mean you should rush to upgrade your training. Far too many athletes hop from one exercise program to the next long before they've had enough time to reap any meaningful benefits. And I strongly believe that the constant rush to change originates from our technological era. Young athletes have grown up in a world that is changing at the speed of light. It's almost hard to blame these kids for assuming that they must constantly change. Final thoughts. In summary, don't let the rapid rate of technological change fool you to believe that your training is no longer relevant or useful. As I've said before, we aren't the first generation to figure out how to challenge and strengthen the body. When it comes to exercise and training, new rarely equals better. Exercises such as hill sprints haven't stood the test of time without good reason. If they didn't work, someone would have figured it out a long time ago. You can't just run the hills for a week and assume you're done, however. Hard work must be coupled with consistency. In other words, you need to stick with an exercise long enough for it to produce results. Constantly jumping from one exercise to the next is perhaps the fastest way to go nowhere. Once you find what works, don't be so quick to discard it. True gems like hill sprints will always produce results. I've run hills for over 20 years and credit much of my endurance to the exercise. There is no doubt that I wouldn't be the same without them. You just listened to the post titled, Technology Changes Faster Than Us, by Ross Enamait of rostraining.com. And thank you again to Sleep Number. From military heroes to everyday heroes, the new Sleep Number 360 smart bed helps everyone get the proven quality sleep that will change their life. Sleep Number beds allow you to adjust on each side to your ideal firmness, comfort, and support. And you've heard the importance of sleep right here on this show many times before. Sleep impacts your creativity, your mood, patience, willpower, and physical and mental health. You spend 1/3 of your life asleep. Experience the smart, effortless comfort of the Sleep Number 360 smart bed. During the Veterans Day sale, save $1,000 on the new Sleep Number 360 Special Edition Smart Bed, now only $1,799, plus exclusive savings for military and vets. You'll only find Sleep Number at one of their 600 Sleep Number stores nationwide. Find one near you at sleepnumber.com/OHD. Dr. Neil here for my commentary. I really appreciated when Ross mentioned that you don't want to just hop back and forth between one exercise routine to the next. Without giving each routine enough time, enough consistency, you're really not going to know whether it's the right routine for you, whether it's going to help you achieve the results that you've been looking for. I've been in the unfortunate situation where I've stuck to routines for far too long and have been told that my body looks exactly the same as it did 5 years before. That's probably one of the worst insults you could ever hear when you've been working really consistently and really hard to make sure that your body has changed aesthetically, only to learn that you still look the same as you did 5 years before. True story, that's what I was told one time. I still remember I would tell people proudly that I'm a proud gym rat, and they would pause, look me up and down and go, "Really?" That was probably that wake-up call that I needed, that I needed to be doing something differently because it's not showing. And so after some denial, I don't think I changed right away. I was like, they don't know what they're talking about. But finally, I did switch up routines. And besides my shoulders still remaining sort of small, I did notice aesthetically my body did change. But again, that was only after I had really given my old routines an honest try. Just my body didn't respond to those. But instead, I've learned my body responds to a different style of training altogether. And so I am glad that people looked me up and down and said, doesn't show that you work out at a gym. All right, that's it from me for today. Thank you for being here. Thank you for listening every day. Have a happy Veterans Day and a big thank you to all of our servicemen and women. And I will see you back here tomorrow where your optimal life awaits.